Hello Data Vaulters, welcome to our series of presentations providing an orientation to Data Vault 2. This is a 7-part series and this video is part 2, where we discuss the pros and cons of the Data Vault 2 solution. Have you ever searched online for Data Vault 2? Despite the fact that the Data Vault method has been around for 15 or more years, if you'd done this a couple of years ago, you would have found very little information. New developments were being discussed between practitioners, not in open forums, and no one had found the time to write a book. Well, today, things have improved significantly. There's a lot more out there to read on the internet, and there are some blogs and LinkedIn groups that you can join. This has resulted in significant growth in interest in the Data Vault 2 method and its potential for agile warehousing. There's a way to go yet, but content is going in the right direction. Recently, a book was published, written by Dan Linstedt, the inventor of the method, and Michael Olshimka, a thought leader based in Germany. The book provides full details of how to build a Data Vault 2 warehouse, including sample code. Since the book was written, the method has moved on in areas, and there are plans to write further volumes. No one's saying that there's a perfect method to develop a data warehouse. There are alternative methods out there, and each method has its own signature features. All of these methods work. Their features may help or hinder, depending on the project circumstances or the problem to be solved. So what are today's needs for a data warehouse? Well, there's a trend for agile working, data protection, larger data sets, real-time processing, and an increased use of data across the organisation. Data Vault 2 is designed to deliver a system that addresses these features. It makes it a particularly suitable method for agile data warehousing projects. Data Vault 2 is not very well publicised. Some of our clients want to keep it a secret to stop competitors copying them, as the Data Vault 2 gives them a competitive advantage. Wherever you look, it does not take long to find someone who is using Data Vault 2. And we've set up the UK Data Vault 2 user group to provide a voice to the growing Data Vault 2 community in the UK and to promote the method to a wider audience. Data Vault 1, the original version, focused on data modelling. Data Vault 2 expands that to cover a wider scope. It adds architectural components, performance management, operations, and guidance on linking the method to agile development practices. Data Vault 2 is also evolving. Each year, thought leaders attend the worldwide Data Vault 2 conference to present their latest ideas and developments. Many of these are added to the growing base of Data Vault 2 techniques and applications. So when's it good to apply the Data Vault 2 method? Well, when you need to be agile. It supports incremental delivery, so your system can grow in small steps. It also means you can get a small production system up, running, and delivering value reasonably quickly. Data Vault 2 works with small to huge data sets. There are examples of multi-petabyte applications updating in near real time. Other applications have smaller, more complex data sets. So this means that data volumes should not be a problem for your project. Data Vault 2 also integrates your data if you have multiple source systems. It will assemble similar data around key business entities. This is important as the greatest insights are often found when you combine data from different sources. Data Vault 2's loading patterns add metadata. This helps trace when you receive data and where it came from. Data Vault 2 data warehouses can handle different types of data: regular structured data, semi-structured data such as log files, and media feeds with raw content. Data Vault 2 uses automation patterns, and this means you don't have to write lots of new software. So we have a customer who has reduced 100,000 lines of ETL code across multiple SQL files just to one ETL program driven by metadata. That means you can reduce the team size. You don't need all those ETL programmers. There are good examples of real-time data feeds working with Data Vault 2, and these can be Internet of Things data streams. Structures such as transactional links and partitioning make it easy to scale up to have parallel loading insert-only tables. Data Vault 2 is also easy to rewind and replay. This means that the consequences of bad design decisions are not terminal. Just throw away what you did wrong, modify the mapping, and run the load again. Or even have both the old and new run in parallel. Flexibility is a strength. Now, Data Vault 2 system also has some consequences. It can produce a lot of tables. This is not necessarily a problem with automation, but you need to be organized with naming and location standards. You will spend more time doing data analysis and building data models. This is because the lower level work is automated with metadata derived from that model and mapping. Data Vault 2 makes it fast to import data by deferring business rules to the end when data is extracted. This means that when you get to extract data, you have to apply these rules. They have to be built somewhere. And Data Vault 2 has a business vault concept for holding common derivations, and it also uses PIT and bridge tables to speed up data extract. And as you'll see, it is possible to construct star schemas directly from the vault layer. Proportionately more time will be spent analysing and building business rules. And, maybe a good thing, the method can use a wide range of technologies, but it leaves that choice to you. If you need to get hold of more detailed information, you can download user group presentations from the user group website. We also offer Data Vault 2 and information governance related blogs and white papers from our company site. These are all worth checking out. Thanks for viewing the video. See you in the next.